So amazing.
Alvin can get it.
Are you done or you still got more food?
Just a couple more things. Would you guys eat? You guys
no, ready? I'm gonna put.
This is just one part of my ginormous family that stretches from East Coast, Virginia, Florida to Maine, all the way to Texas, to California, and all the states in between, to Dubai, to the Philippines. One thing that I want the world to remember, something that we always talk about here at One Championship, is the fact it takes a village. It takes a village for any one big goal to come to fruition. My cheat meal today and tomorrow is hamburgers and hot dogs.
This time I think that with the meal plans that he's incorporating, I think that it makes timing that much easier and one less thing to follow. Big difference is the discipline with those meal plans, actually adhering to those. We've hung out and in the past, he's usually a pretty big eater, big guy, and he's been really strict on sticking to those meal plans. Sometimes, you know, with the weight cuts, you can get a little cranky, and I've seen none of that this camp. I've seen only happiness and really enjoying the process.
Okay, one more question.
Yes, ma'am.
One more question.
Get Uncle Brandon's face, not it.
One more question. Make this one a good one. No, ma'am. We do not smoke. Smoking is bad for you.
Okay,
nothing.
The end.
What?
The end.
The end. Okay, that's the end. Smoking is bad for you. I ate exactly one hot dog, one tri-tip beef patty, 4 pieces of bacon, 3 ribs, less than a quarter cup of rice, and some Fena Denny sauce, and 2 bottles of water. And I only know this because we're cutting to light heavyweight, and I'm paying attention to everything that I'm eating. Kind of sucks, but it's part of the gig. I want that light heavyweight title. That's the job I applied for, 225 pounds. Thank you guys for coming to the barbecue. Thanks for seeing how we live our simple life. And watching my niece interview me.
We're at Hard Knock 365, getting ready for a big, you know, match coming up in October 13th against Brendan Vera. Today is our sparring day. You know, it's a meat grinder day. You don't get any easy rounds. You can never come in half prepared. You're gonna get beat up. It's gonna be an amazing camp. We're gonna be ready for this one for sure.
Ready? Of course he's ready. He's shown everybody already. He's a double champ. And he took this fight because he don't need to take that fight. He's a middleweight. And he has a light heavyweight belt. And now he's fighting a heavyweight guy. So that shows enough that he's ready. He's a martial artist. So is Brendan Vera. He's a veteran. He's a really good fighter too. And a really good person. What I see from him and the way I know him, he's a very good guy too. So it's going to be an amazing fight. But everybody knows that Aung Lah come to fight. Everybody's seen that in the past. You know, he's coming to fight. So it will be a hell of a fight.
Just time, ready? Ready? Michael Ciavello, Mitch Chilson-Riki. Main event from Yangon, Myanmar. It's World Championship. Aung Lah San, tremendous power in his roundhouse kicks, in his punches. So too, the thickly built Ken Hasegawa.
Aung Lah San looks very intense, while Hasegawa looks very relaxed.
A new training camp for Aung Lah San in Fort Lauderdale, Florida.
That right hand of Aung Lah snuck right through the guard.
Right roundhouse kick from Aung Lah San. Hasegawa, the deep megaton, open weight champion. Comes here very well credentialed. Left hand there from Ken Hasegawa. Aung Lah showing patience, edges forward as the champion. Probing with the jab out of southpaw stance, Ken Hasegawa. jab to the cross there from Hasegawa. Just falls short for the Japanese martial artist. Outside leg kick misses the target from Aung Lan Sang. Second one connects for Aung Lan.
Hasegawa's starting to find a home for that left hand. He's trying to gauge the distance as he's cutting through the guard of Aung Lan. Right there, just landed again.
The left drops, the power cross of the southpaw from Japan. Body shot off the lead hand from Aung Lan. Aung Lan two-punch combination, grazing with the left. Goes to southpaw stance Aung Lan.
Aung Lan's landed a few times though, but Hasegawa's wearing it well.
Jab there from Aung Lan Sang, switches back to orthodox stance now. There's the champion. Hasegawa threads the high left roundhouse kick.
Nice little combination from Hasegawa, left hand, left kick.
They're gonna change levels perhaps, mix it up a little here. Again, Hasegawa almost circles into that right roundhouse kick. The roundhouse kick that knocked out Machado. Fake there from Aung Lan. Thought about throwing the right hand down the tube. Resets from center cage. Left cross falls short for Hasegawa. An intriguing half a round down so far. Roundhouse kick to the upper left ribs there from Aung Lan.
These guys are very similar. Like they have very almost duplicate styles, like they're going against a mirror. They've got the same jab straight combination, same big roundhouse kick coming off the rear leg.
Every time Aung Lan lands, this crowd goes crazy. A sellout again inside the mighty Toyota Indoor Stadium. High right roundhouse kick there for Aung Lan. Two-punch combination, Hasegawa had some fire on the lead hand. Both men showing tremendous respect for the capabilities of one another. They give instruction coming from the corner. Gets out of the way, the two-punch combo. Hasegawa resets. The southpaw from Japan. Oh, the right hand! Smack bang! Smack bang! First real power salvo from Aung Lan Sang. And Hasegawa rallies back. Aung Lan applying the pressure, coming forward. Hasegawa locking eyes with the champion. Step three knee, and Hasegawa backs him off with the right hand. Both men showing some terrific boxing so far here, Mitch.
These are big middleweights putting a lot of power behind these heavy hands.
Hasegawa, a game opponent with 25 seconds on the clock.
Hasegawa competing against one of the best middleweights in the world, the best middleweight in the world, but he's also got these 10,000 Myanmar fans against him as well.
And we are told that one in every three of this country of 55 million is watching live, watching their hero, Aung Lan Sang, defend the middleweight world title.
Take a look at some of Aung Lan's shots here. Look at that, he caught a kick. Caught a right hand on the chin, and then he got hit with a kick. That was the best combination of Ken Hasegawa, but Aung Lan comes right back with a nice overhand right of his own. Back and forth action, very close first round.
Wherever you're watching in 138 countries around the world, or live on the One Super App, we hope you're enjoying all the madness, all the mayhem, all the martial arts magnificence. That is one championship from Yangon, Myanmar. The middleweight world title of that match. Aung Lan Sang is on the line. He's a two-division champion.
Some wise words coming off of Henry Hooft, the head coach for Aung Lan Sang. As he tells me, he wants to make sure that he covers up a little bit better, make sure he puts his hands nice and tight to the chin.
Round two. second round set for five. We're seeing a fantastic toe-to-toe matchup so far. Roundhouse kick to the ribs there from Aung Lan. Thumping right hand down the center corridor from the champion. Hasegawa backs him off with the lead hand. Power in both hands of the southpaw.
Hasegawa starting to march forward. Trying to put punches together in bunches.
Aung Lan's got to keep that left hand up because the right lead of Hasegawa is finding the mark.
That's what Henry Hove told him. He said he wants to keep his hands nice and close to his chin. A little bit of a slip there from Aung Lan.
A very humid atmosphere inside Tawana Indoor Stadium. Long side, looks to get on the inside. Hasegawa almost walked into that rising knee.
Hasegawa's starting to push forward a bit more on his boxing. Cutting a little bit of angles. This is typically what we see from Aung Lan. Aung Lan likes to pivot out to the right and left very well.
A hook to a left cross there.
Look at the welt starting to develop on Hasegawa's left rear.
It is purple and deep red from the roundhouse kicks off the back leg of Aung Lan Sang. Hasegawa fights. Aung Lan fires out a front kick. Those booming chants go up again for Aung Lan Sang. He drops one down to the belly button. Hasegawa threads the left cross nicely. He's got a bit of pepper behind it. Aung Lan looks to close the gap. Backwards, clips him with a short right hook.
Looks like that caught him off balance though as Aung Lan stumbles backwards and a nice left or right hand from Hasegawa.
Hasegawa again, a popping jab, takes another rib kick. Hasegawa's got some fire in his hands. Aung Lan taking his time, not overextending himself, not rushing. A cerebral performance from the champion. Jab cross combo there from the challenger. The cross lands again, but he didn't have the torque. He didn't turn into it. Toe to toe. Hasegawa comes forward, straight line punches. A high right roundhouse kick from Aung Lan. Hasegawa backs him off with another cross. Aung Lan takes two solid blows to the jaw. Got to keep the hands up the champion. This is a good boxing spell here, Mitch, from the challenger.
And Hasegawa's really putting his punches together nicely. He's finding the home, he's finding that range with his jab and his counter strike, and he's looking clean. Very good round so far for Hasegawa.
Hasegawa.
Burmese Python has a really good guillotine, so Hasegawa's got to be careful, make sure he keeps his head high on that entry.
Edges forward again, does the check. Aung Lan Sang, second round set for five for the world middleweight title clutch. Middle dipping body shot at the right hand there from Aung Lan. Flips him with a left hook. Body shot from Aung Lan. Throws out the front kick. What a battle we are seeing for the world title. Aung Lan, right hand lead. Hasegawa threads a right hand of his own, that being the lead hand of the southpaw.
In those close distance exchanges, that's Hasegawa's best time. He's starting to catch Aung Lan when Aung Lan's lightning's left.
Hasegawa cuts on the side of the right eye.
Ooh, nice hook, straight combo.
Hasegawa jab two, follows through with another right hand. Off the right of his arm, and Hasegawa now toe to toe. Aung Lan goes to the body, Hasegawa goes to the draw. Back and forth action to close out the second round. Yangon, and I'm sure around the world, loving every moment of this world title match. And there's one of our luminaries, heavyweight superstar Alan Galani, here cageside.
And who's the other guy? Po Ta, another Myanmar superstar. Look at this action, watch this. Aung La tries to come up the middle with an uppercut just as Hasegawa attacks that low leg, sweeps it out from under him, creating a slight stumble from the champion. Hasegawa comes marching forward, throws two punches. Aung La fades out of the way, boom, comes back with one of his own. The back and forth action is just tremendous as Hasegawa lands a big right hook.
Fantastic back and forth action. Both men landing heavy shoulders. The handiwork of Hasegawa in the second round. But there's a good look at the cut and a very dangerous spot. And there's the champion as he defends the crown. Third round of five.
Little mouse under the eye of the champion. Little cut under the eye of the challenger. Third round, here we go.
And sweat flies off the brow of both as they both land punches. There's it. Flipping overhand, left out of southpaw starts from Aung La. Hasegawa backs him off with the left hand. A beautiful left hook there from Hasegawa. A double jab from the Japanese challenger.
That reverberated all throughout the stadium.
Hasegawa back to the left once more. Now it's on the top. Oh, the uppercut.
The uppercut.
Puts the
chin
over the top of the head.
I think that kick rocked Hasegawa. Aung La's feeling it.
Here comes Aung La. And Hasegawa backs him against the fence. A high knee from Aung La outside. This is going to be crazy in the third round. Now they go to the ground for the first time. Hasegawa looks to pass to go to side control.
Oh, Hasegawa is able to get past the guard of the Burmese Python. This is where Hasegawa excels. He is so strong in this position. Look for him to drop elbows and try to crucifix.
Sung back to his feet, drills a body shot. This crowd is crazy. Uppercut from Aung La. Hasegawa tags him. Looks for the uppercut again. A downward elbow. A crossing elbow. Hasegawa does a quick count of his teeth. Aung La goes for the body. Trying to soften up the midsection. Hasegawa breathing heavy. There's a huge mouse swelling up the right eye of Aung San Suu. Uppercut from the champion.
The challenger's mouth is wide open, but he's still coming forward. Aung La wisely starts to go to the body.
This is like something out of a Hollywood movie. Back and forth, a slugfest. Solid left cross there from Hasegawa. Aung La throws a roundhouse kick. The champ comes forward again. A bolo punch from the champion. A body rip to the liver. Hasegawa to the head. Turn and turn once more. This is guts. An intestinal fortitude personified. Both men letting it all hang out. They're pulling out all the stops.
Guys have bit down on their mouthpiece and are just throwing hands.
This is what they came to see. This is pure theater. A right hand lands from Aung San Suu. A wild leaping left is in southpaw stance for Chan. Hasegawa backs him off. Hasegawa's hands around his waist. This is epic. This is awesome.
The left eye of Aung La is starting to swell shut. Hasegawa is marching forward, landing shots.
What a show! It's pure box office. A spinning backfist attempt from Hasegawa. Here comes Aung San Suu. Chota again. They're giving it their all. This is one for the ages. Aung goes to the body.
Michael, and this is the only the third round. 40 seconds left.
Hasegawa lands across to the jaw. Jab from the challenger. Jab two. This has been amazing. The atmosphere, the battle, the moment.
I like how Aung La is starting to go to the body. He's mixing it up. Hasegawa is just headhunting. Aung La is attacking the body just as much as he's attacking the head. Take a look at some of this action. There was a big exchange, but then the counter off the right hands, but then Aung La landed a sneaky uppercut with his right. Constant action from these two as they go toe to toe, back and forth, just landing big punches. Now, Michael, this is unseen territory for the challenger, Ken Hasegawa. He has never been into the championship rounds. He has never needed to see a fourth and fifth, and Aung La lives in deep water.
But look at the damage on Aung La's face, a sight we never see. Both eyes are swollen, also the damage on Ken Hasegawa. This has been something extraordinary. Fourth round, the penultimate round. They call these the championship round. It is one championship from Yangon, Myanmar, and it is a blockbuster. The cage door closes. Aung La's first stolen shot. And Hasegawa, as Mitch said, has to dig deep, has to go to a place inside of himself that he's never been to before. Is when it becomes more than physical. Hasegawa shoots in, Aung La stops the takedown.
And Aung La is trying to transition to the back. Hasegawa caught him, the mouth guard goes out.
Knees to the ribs. That'll make it even harder. Hasegawa wobbling around the cage. How much more does the challenger have left? It has been an absolute beauty, a rip slaughter. Aung La with the right hand, the body shots. Hasegawa tags him with the left cross. Hasegawa again. Both these men, more punch than a high school prom. There's a right hand from Aung La. There's a stiff uppercut. It's all boxing now. They're fighting on spirit.
Keeping Aung La going is this crowd. This is when the crowd is going to lift you and drive you because you're competing for something bigger than yourself. You're competing for all these thousands of people that are rooting you on. Thank you.
on the jabs, walking forward. Aung's going to be wondering, what do I have to throw to make this man quit? What do I have to throw to knock this man out? But Hasegawa's still here. He's not going to wave the white flag. He's not going to go quietly into the night. And Hasegawa throws hands again.
Hasegawa has never been knocked out. Not once in his entire career has he been put to sleep. And this is why. These guys, their heads must be made of concrete as they trade big leather.
This is like a Rocky movie. This is like Creed versus Balboa. And it's Aung versus Hasegawa. A nice little trip takedown there from Aung. He's got the back. 1 minute remaining, fourth round of five.
1 minute left in the fourth round.
Throwing the back there, goes to the knees.
Knee to the head of Hasegawa. Continue to inflict damage.
I'd like him to go knees to the body. He's got the space. He can knee to the body here.
How is Hasegawa surviving? This is insane. The left hand from Aung San.
Up one hook goes in. Aung might take the back with 30 seconds to go.
Can Hasegawa survive the round? Aung San tries to get the second hook in to no avail. It's a turtle shell here from Hasegawa. Olivia Post having a look at Hasegawa's face. Aung San punishes him even more. The electricity in here. You can feel it. Every hair in your body is tingling.
Wobbled, but Ken Hasegawa looks the worst of the two. But wow, look at this grappling exchange right here. Hasegawa continues to push forward. Aung sprawls out very heavy, gets control there in the clinch, throws a knee to the body as the mouthpiece goes down. Here was how they finished the round. Aung rolls into the rear naked choke. Looks like he's face cranking there. The choke's not in, it's a face crank. Hasegawa defends the hooks very well, still aware, completely aware of his surroundings, able to scramble back up on top, and then to finish with Aung on top. What a match!
One more round to go. Will Hasegawa crack? Or has he got the turbo to put the foot down in the business end, in the final round? Amazing scenes. There are matches across all sports that go down in history as simply unforgettable. This is one of them. This is unforgettable. And look at the sportsmanship. Look at the martial arts code of honor. Hasegawa is seeing out of one eye.
Hasegawa's got to keep his guard up. That right eye is almost swollen shut as Aung marches forward as he's looking the fresher of the two.
Both men throwing punches. A gripping left hand there from Aung San's son and sends the mouth guard of Hasegawa flying.
After this you run when your mouth hangs open like that, one well-placed punch and your mouthpiece will pop out.
Hasegawa jabs, backs off the champion with the left cross. Anything can happen. In the sport of transition milliseconds, spin it back over! The inner left way of Aung San coming out on that occasion. A curling lead hand from the challenger. Backs up the champion again. Aung San dances out of trouble. Goes to the body. Hasegawa misses with the lead uppercut. The crowd on the edge of their seats. In fact, most of them here are standing. Their national hero, Aung San, the most famous man in Myanmar. 3 minutes 20 away. Possibly retaining his championship. We said Hasegawa on paper was his toughest opponent ever. Certainly that has been the case. Aung puts all his stuff behind the right hand. A jab at a southpaw stance.
What a beautiful trip takedown as Aung gets on top. Hasegawa's defending the hooks, and he can't let Aung wrap his legs around his body, but he gets back up.
Hasegawa defends. He's back to his feet, almost halfway through the round. A jab from the champion. A cross and a jab from the arm-heavy challenger. On Hasegawa, extraordinary victory ability. Aung Lau resets, goes to the midsection of the lead hand, eats a nice stiff jab from Hasegawa. Aung Lau switches back to his preferred orthodox stance. Under 2 minutes remaining, a knee to the midsection from the champion. Out of jam. Body shots. Hasegawa is ready to go.
Stadium.